red light, green light. Everybody take a shot. Red light, green light. Give me everything you got. Red light.
Mr. 305, Flow Rider and Lunch Money. Three Miami boys, you know what time it is.
Give me the green light. Cause I'm ready to go. Let's have a good time.
Let's go.
What you waiting for? You only got one life.
One life.
And we gon' live it up. So give me the green light. Cause I'm ready to go.
What I preach, if you know what I mean. I'm about that, mommy. Yeah, I got the key and I'ma lock that, mommy. Yeah, we can roll and I'ma rock that, mommy. I do what I say and say what I mean. Now let me jump in between them.
One of those guys where no matter when you see him, he's always got a smile on his face. He's always excited to see you. He's the true definition of a brother. P's gonna be successful no matter what he does. And we're gonna miss you, P.
Miss Pierre, I miss hanging out with Pierre all the time on off the court. He's a good guy, he's classy.
I'm gonna miss the most about Pierre is just, brotherhood. He's my roommate, and he just has a warm heart. Like, he's always there for me.
The moment with Pierre was just hanging out with him every single day in the locker room and making jokes with the team and, you know, just becoming closer as a team.
Probably around the first week I met him or so, I wasn't that familiar with him, and I went over to his dorm just to hang out with him, and he just shared his life story with me, and his accent was what caught me at first. It's pretty funny, but I think his life story was really interesting. I just like him.
Well, to me, I'll probably say just every time when me and him are sitting next to each other during the game, he's always talking to me and I'm always talking to him. He's like, yeah, I see, you know, every time you go in, you know, you do this on offense or this on defense, and he's always talking to me and I'm always talking to him. So just always having him around.
You know, Lamine always has her back. He's a great teammate. One of the nicest guys I know. I miss him a lot.
Micah Denauer, it's hard to pick one thing. I think he's just one of the greatest guys I've ever had a chance to be around. He's got an infectious personality, and he was just a great friend, great teammate, great roommate. And Mike, we love you, we're gonna miss you. I'm gonna miss you, and best of luck to everyone.
Micah's just a good guy to have on the team in general. I mean, he's a fun guy to have in the locker room, good to talk to him. But he's also a great leader, and he leads kind of almost by example. He's not incredibly vocal, but he'll definitely voice his opinion when it's necessary. He's a really smart leader, and definitely a good person to have.
He's just a winner. He loves winning, and he's just a great guy to be around. He's unselfish, and even though I think he was the best on the team, he didn't like act like he was the best. He didn't have an ego. He was just open with everybody and just loved everybody on the team equally.
There's a lot, but probably just hanging out, just cracking lots of jokes on mine.
It just feels amazing, you know. I just really wanted to get this win for the team, for the guys. We really needed it. We knew we needed it. We were gonna get it, but I just wanted to just end off with a note that, you know, I tried my best. I gave everything I had.
Jalen was always a great leader. Just by showing his actions on the court, he used to lead us to most of our victories. And most people don't know Jalen was one of our hardest workers off the court. He was always in the gym showing us, like, getting shots up, thousands of shots up every week, and just leading us to a great season.
The part about being teammates with Jalen is, he's just like, since we got here, he took me under his wing. He played that big brother role for me, and, you know, he just showed me the way and how to do certain things.
With Jalen, for me, I really saw him as like one of our all-stars on the team, somebody that we could just give the ball to and he could just like literally just go and get a bucket.
My favorite memory about Jalen Richard was probably when he put Dude in the rim against San Francisco State, and I remember looking over at our bench and seeing our whole bench like doing backflips. It was awesome, man. So Jay, we're gonna miss you, man, and best of luck to everything.
I'm gonna miss his excitement. Every time he came to practice, he just loved being there and loved seeing all the guys, and I'm just gonna miss how much he cared about all the guys and the passion that he put into the game.
I'm really gonna miss him being in practice with him, you know, throughout the whole year. We have a lot of workouts, even preseason, regular season, postseason. Just having him around, you know, he was our leader last year, and just having him, you know, trying to get us motivated, you know, having his energy in practice.
Me and Pond got to develop a pretty good relationship. We're teammates for 4 years. I came in as a freshman. He was a redshirt freshman. Me and Pond, we used to get along real well in my freshman year. I mean, we still do, but we had a lot of inside jokes. A couple of things going on with one of our old teammates, Ryan Heber, fan. We'd always talk about stuff. We had lockers right next to each other. So we became real close in the last 4 years.
Best memory about Pond, we was in a game together, and he got fouled, and he got fouled real hard and finished, and he was playing the five. And I just told him, like, Pond, you a beast. And he just looked at me and just started smiling. And that's my favorite memory of Pond. Ever since then, I've heard Pond is just a beast out there on the court.
The thing I'm going to miss most about Pond is the energy he brought every day.
Trey had a lot of good memories on the court and off the court. I think, honestly, one of my favorite memories from Trey was he would come up with our apartment sometimes. We would just hang out and just play video games and just chit-chat about whatever and just have a good time and just hang out and just be social with each other. We got to talk to.
It would be just every day before practice, me and him would always look each other in the eye and do a little joke, say boy and stuff like that.
My favorite part about being teammates with Trey is that he brought it every single day in practice and in games. He always won. He always gave it 100%.
Trey was always positive, always kept a smile on his face. You never seen him down. Like, he was always that one guy on the team that even when practice was going bad, he was always having a smile on his face, trying to get everybody up, encouraging, and never had a bad attitude at any time.
Season senior night, and I just
want
to come out and do whatever I can.
They've been their special guys to me in my life, and you just want the best for them. You want them to experience like the joy of that. So to have them do it on the last night, and to walk out of our gym and feel like that, there's not a lot of teams that get to end on a win, and so I'm glad that they got to end on a win and end their legacy with that. So I'm really happy for them.